lo and behold, everything from dull yellow light became like a three-dimensional, like a three-dimensional tunnel that was just, you know, hovering over the ground.
Where there's a light shining from, coming out from within this opening. On the other side of the opening, it's just a natural background branch. They see the road, they see the grass from the pasture and so forth.
Slowly, this incident unfolded where they saw this, what looked like a humanoid creature, crawling, literally elbowing his or her way through this tunnel, hovering 4 feet above the ground.
And out of this opening crawls a very large, what I understood to be an 8 foot tall, black creature with a head and no neck, and a torso, arms and legs. No details or features noted on it.
It was a second witness standing right beside the other guy with the infrared technology. All he could see was a dull yellow light that had expanded to about 4 feet in diameter.
It just literally grabbed the outside edges of this opening, pulled itself through, came out, stepped onto the dirt road, and ran off into the darkness.
The creature stood up. Once it got out onto the ground and walked away into the darkness. I mean, can you imagine two people on the top of a cliff or a sort of a bluff, 150 feet off the ground, in the middle of nowhere?
And then the opening began to shrink and collapse in on itself and turn into a brilliant light that just faded away. That's a perfect description that was given by Matt Visser and Sean Kramer and Bob Ford and other colleagues of theirs in a physical review paper on the optical nature of wormholes.
I mean, that is not, I would say, military technology. That's some kind of a phenomena that has its smikes or interdimensional phenomena.
We don't know. We don't know what it is. That was one theory. Those guys don't know. They're just, you know, throwing out one idea and telling you what they actually saw. They had some really harrowing encounters on the property themselves. It was those two guys were walking again in the middle of the homestead at night. They had a couple of dogs with them, and the dogs suddenly go behind their legs. They're scared of something, and up at the top of the trees, they see this dark cloud that's floating. It's floating up across the trees, getting bigger and bigger, and it stops right in front of them, and they freeze. And this thing, Eric Davis, who's a PhD physicist, brilliant man, has worked for top secret labs and things, he's frozen, and suddenly another voice comes out of him. It's not his, it's them. We're watching you.
Whoa.
He's saying this, we're watching you. I was looking at him like, and it's not him, it's somebody else speaking through him. He snaps out of it after a couple of minutes. The cloud goes away. Eric was messed up for a couple of days, having terrible dreams, couldn't sleep. But it was a real thing. There were other weird things that they investigated. So, you know, we decided when we wrote the book, we're going to put them all in, and people can sort it out themselves. The only incident that we hesitated about, that we argued about maybe leaving out, is this one. Two Native American police officers are driving through their range. I told you the whole ranch is surrounded by tribal land. There's a road, there's a paved road that leads to the dirt road that leads into the ranch. They're coming around the bend, it's nighttime, and they see two figures standing right at the bend. Their backs are to the road. The guys shine their lights over there. What are these two guys up to? Two 6 foot tall guys in trench coats smoking cigarettes. They shine a light over to them. The guys turn around their heads. They're dogs. I don't know, I'm not making that up. They're dogs. They have dog faces. These Indian cops look at each other. Holy crap. They look back. Dogs are gone. Trench coat's gone. They get out of the car. Cigarettes still burning on the ground. Now, we thought, maybe we'll leave that one out. That sounds pretty crazy. But you know what? I mean, since the book came out in 2005, there's all kinds of dog man stories that we've been hearing from around the country. So we kept it in. You know, the NIDS guys tried to communicate with whatever it was. They had different experiments. They tried to talk to whatever it is, and that failed. After a while of hunting the skinwalker got tired of the game and decided, I'm going away. The activity plummeted. It went underground. And the phenomena seemed to make a statement that it was tired of this. One thing it did. Well, let's play this link on the bottom.
1978, a local newspaper reported high activity in the river basin. Silver dollar-shaped objects were seen, flying saucers. Some witnesses observing the display from close proximity, from underneath the craft.